Hello friends, welcome back to Food for Ear. I am Maunika. Hope you all are good and safe. Welcome you all to learn HTML. Happy to see you all again in this HTML course. A warm welcome to you all. In today's video, we are going to code a simple exercise which is related to forms. And also, I am going to summarize all concepts of HTML forms in today's video. In previous video, we discussed some of the new form fields which are available in HTML5, right? We discussed some of the input types, namely number inputs, email inputs, date inputs, range inputs, URL inputs, search inputs, time inputs, and weak inputs, right? And also we discussed how to code appropriate form fields with the help of these input types, right? We discussed the purpose of required attribute, min attribute, max attribute, step attribute, and so on, right? And finally, we discussed about the legend tag, right? If we want to provide a title for a set of related form fields, we will be using legend tag, right? These steps we discussed detailedly in previous video. So if you don't know those steps, or if you didn't watch my previous videos, I will provide link of my entire playlist detailed HTML course in my description box. Kindly check over there. I request you to watch my previous videos, because if you watch my previous videos, you can get a better continuity over here. Okay, now let's enter into today's video. Before entering into today's video, if you didn't subscribe our channel, kindly subscribe our channel and click the bell icon so that you will receive all notifications of my useful videos then and there. Okay. Now, without further delay, let's enter into today's video. Yes, this is what we are going to discuss in today's video. We are going to code a simple exercise which is related to forms. We are going to code exercise number 8. In previous videos, we coded till exercise number 7, right? At last, we coded an exercise which is related to tables concept, right? So in today's video, we are going to code exercise number 8, which is related to the concept of forms. This exercise covers all concept of HTML forms. And also, I'm going to summarize all concepts of HTML forms in today's video. As I said earlier, exercises are most important. So please don't skip this video. If you code this exercise, you can develop your knowledge about HTML forms in a better manner. So after learning all concepts of HTML forms, please try to solve this exercise. If you solve this exercise, you will get a chance to test yourself. Right? Yes. So please don't skip this video. Please don't skip this exercise. Right? Okay. Now, without further delay, let me show you the exercise page. Yes, this is what your exercise, right? So first of all, let me explain the question in detail, or else we can say, let me explain the requirements, right? Let me explain the need, right? First, you need to code this heading, simple exercise for forms, right? After that, you need to code this particular field, first name field, okay, password field, upload picture, okay, this field, okay. If I click this upload picture, it should open this, right? Then you need to code this particular radio buttons, and you need to code this particular thing, your knowledge level in HTML. You need to code these fields with the help of appropriate input types and appropriate tags, right? Here, HTML should get selected by default, right? And you need to group these 5 fields with the help of appropriate tag, right? And you need to provide title as user's information for these set of related fields using appropriate tag, right? Then if I click this label, appropriate field should get selected. If I click password, then appropriate field should get selected. If I click upload picture, it should open this particular thing, right? Then if I click HTML, it should get selected. HTML should get selected by default. If I click this particular label CSS, this particular radio button should get selected. If I click this JavaScript, this particular radio button should get selected. If I click this label, your knowledge level in HTML, this particular field should get highlighted, right? You need to code like this. Then here you can see admin, right? So admin should be the default value for first name. If I remove this admin, here user should see enter your first name. You need to code this text in your source code with the help of appropriate attribute, right? Then user can enter something, right? Here you need to code first name, password and upload picture as mandatory fields, right? So you need to use appropriate attribute. Means if user didn't enter anything for first name, password and upload picture, it should show error like this. See, if I click this particular send button, it should show please fill out this field, right? Then if I click this send button again, it should show please fill out this field for password, right? Why? Because I didn't enter any input for password. So if user didn't enter any input for password, it should show this error message, right? And if I didn't upload any file, then also it should show error message, right? So likewise, you need to code these things, right? Okay, next, you need to code these fields, right? You need to code this email field, phone number field, Twitter URL field and country field, right? You need to code these fields with the help of appropriate input types and appropriate tag, right? So if I click email, appropriate field should get highlighted. Similarly for phone number also, for Twitter URL also, for country also. Okay, so this should be drop down menu, right? So in the drop down menu, if I click this arrow, I need to see these things. Like I need to see these country: India, Malaysia, Singapore, China, Pakistan, America and others, right? And here select your country should be there. If I click this, I need to see this. I need to select my appropriate country. Likewise, you need to code it, right? And here you need to see these text: enter your email address, enter your phone number, enter your Twitter URL. Like that, I need to see these text, right? So you need to do this with the help of appropriate attribute. Then you need to group these fields with the help of appropriate tag, and you need to provide title as contact details for these set of fields with the help of appropriate tag, right? Okay, then after coding these things, you need to code this particular search field. If I click this particular search, appropriate field should get highlighted. Here you can see some text, right? Browse anything if you need. You need to code that particular text in your source code with the help of appropriate attribute. Next, comments. If I click this particular label, this particular thing should get highlighted, right? Inside it, this text should be visible. If you have any comments, please enter here. Like that, this text should be visible, right? Then at last, you need to code these two checkboxes. By default, these two checkboxes should get enabled, right? If I click this label, okay, I understand and agree with the privacy policy. If I click this label, this field should get disabled. If I click this label again, this field should get enabled. Similarly, here also, if I click this label, this field should get disabled. If I again click this label, this field should get enabled, right? By default, these two fields or these two checkboxes should get enabled. You need to code this in your source code, right? At last, you need to code this particular send button, right? Like that, you need to code, okay? Now, let me tell some restrictions. See, here default name is admin, right? So if user erases this particular thing, user should see this text, enter your first name, right? So if user enter unlimited characters here, it is not fair, right? So you need to restrict this for 30 characters. That means if user presses 31st character in their keyboard, okay, in their keyboard, it should not accept. You need to code like this, right? Then this field also should be like this. This field should be capable of displaying 25 characters in a column and 5 rows. This field should be capable of displaying 25 characters in a line, or we can say in a line, right? And it should display 5 rows, okay? It should display 5 rows. Likewise, you need to code, okay? Here some of the fields are mandatory fields, okay? Let me tell the mandatory fields once again. If I click send button, okay, so first name field is mandatory. You need to code first name field as mandatory field, okay? Then if I click send button, password field is mandatory. So you need to code password field as mandatory field, right? Then if I click send button, this upload picture file is mandatory, right? If you didn't upload any picture, it should show like this. Please select a file like this. So if I click choose file, I can select any file, right? Then if I click send button, phone email field should be mandatory, right? So let me give any email, okay? Then if I click send button, phone number field should be mandatory, right? Let me specify any phone number, right? These 5 fields should be mandatory fields. That means you need to code these 5 fields as mandatory in your source code. If user didn't enter any input for these fields, okay, it should not accept. First name, password, upload picture, email, phone number. These fields should be mandatory fields. And here for the first name, you need to provide a restriction. That means here user can enter at most 30 characters alone. Here for this particular field also, this field should be capable of displaying 25 characters in a line and 5 rows. Okay, this field should be capable of displaying 5 rows, right? Then if I click send, where the data should go? The data should be transferred to a file which contains the programs for the data to be processed, right? So it should go to this particular file, next.php. If I click this send button, it should go to this particular file, next.php. You need to achieve this with the help of appropriate attribute in your source code, right? So this is the file which contains programs for the data to get processed, right? There is no such file in my desktop, so it's showing like this. Your file could not be accessed like this, right? Okay, then after processing, the data should be transmitted to server, right? So I want to transmit data to server behind the scenes, right? So you need to code like this. I don't want to transmit my data explicitly. See, in the URL, you cannot see name value pairs, right? You cannot see query strings, right? So I want to transmit my data behind the scenes. I don't want to transmit my data explicitly, okay? So likewise, the source code should be, right? Likewise, you need to code, right? So these are the requirements. Likewise, you need to code this particular exercise form, right? Okay. Now, please take photo or screenshot of this particular file. Okay, so please take photo or screenshot of this particular file. After taking photo, please pause this video and try to code yourself in your web browser and text editor. After coding successfully, or in between, if you have any doubts, please resume the video and see how I am coding. Yes, now please take the photo or screenshot of this particular page or file, right? Please take the photo. Let me reload and show you. Please take these things. Your form should be like this, okay? So please take the photo. Yes, After taking photo or screenshot, please pass the video and code in your text editor and web browser. Please try to code by yourself without referring internet or some other thing. Right. After coding, or if you have any doubts, please resume the video and see how I am coding. Yes, it's time to pass the video. Yes, hope you have coded successfully. Okay, now let me show my code. Before showing my code, let me summarize all concepts of HTML forms. I'm not going to explain all concepts detailedly again. Why? Because I explained all concepts detailedly in previous videos. So if you don't know those concepts, please refer my previous videos. Link is in my description box. Now I'm going to summarize, means I'm going to tell you, or I'm going to revise you, what are the concepts we have learned so far. Okay, what are the concepts we have learned so far? I'm going to revise, right? So far, in HTML forms, we learned about form tag, right? Means if you want to code a form in your HTML web page, form tag is mandatory. Without the form tag, you cannot code a form tag, right? And we discussed label tag, and we discussed three inputs: text inputs, password inputs, and submit inputs. And we discussed how to code a simple login form in our HTML web page, right? And after that, we discussed how to code radio button, checkbox, and drop-down menu in HTML web page, right? So to code radio button, we used radio inputs. To code checkbox, we used checkbox inputs. To code drop-down menu, we used two tags, select tag and option tag, right? So if you want to get some input, such as phone number or age, we'll be using number inputs, right? After that, we discussed how data is transmitted from our web page to server. That is, we are having two types of data transmission, or we can say two methods of data transmission: get method and post method. If you want your data to be transmitted explicitly, you can use get method, or if you want your data to be transmitted behind the scenes, you can use post method, right? And we discussed size attribute and max length attribute. So if you want to provide some restriction, you will be using size attribute and max length attribute. And we discussed about checked attribute. If you want to select any radio button or any checkbox as default, you can use checked attribute. And we discussed selected attribute. If you want to select any value in drop-down menu as default, we will be using selected attribute. And we discussed about action attributes, right? So if you want your data to get transmitted to the file which contains the programs for the data to get processed, we'll be using action attributes, right? Yes. Then we discussed how to upload a file to server. We discussed file inputs, right? And we discussed encryption type attribute. If you want to transmit a binary data to server, we'll be using encryption type attribute. And we discussed how to select multiple choices in drop-down menu. For that, we discussed multiple attribute, right? And we discussed how to code text area field, and we learned how to code a simple job application form in HTML web page. And we discussed how to link form fields and labels, what is the purpose of linking form fields and labels. And we discussed how to improve form accessibility, and we learned how to group a set of related form fields, and we learned how to give a title for those form fields, right? With the help of field set tag and legend tag, we achieved this, right? And in previous video also, we learned some of the new form fields which are available in HTML file: number field, email field, date field, range field, URL field, search field, time field, and week field. These are some of the new form fields which are available in HTML 5. So these fields will support in modern browser alone. These fields won't support in old browser. These cross-browser issues we can solve by using the technique called polyfill, right? So these concepts we discussed detailedly in previous videos. This is what the overall concept of HTML forms, right? So with the help of these concepts, we coded this particular form in today's video, right? So let me show my code. If you code this particular form successfully, yes, you learn all the concept of HTML forms very well, right? Okay, hope you have coded successfully. Now let me explain this particular thing by using my code, right? Yes, this is what my code, right? So in the title bar you can see exercise for forms, right? So in the title tag I coded exercise for forms, right? Next, this is what heading, right? Simple exercise for forms, this is what heading, right? So in the heading tag, h3 tag, I coded simple exercise for forms. You can use any heading tag, okay? You can use any heading tag according to size. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to code a form in my HTML web page, right? So for that I need to open form tag and I need to close that particular form tag, right? Between opening and closing tag of forms, I can code the content of forms, right? So here I opened form tag, right? And I closed that particular form tag over here. Between opening and closing tag, I coded content, right? Okay. Now here you can see first name, right? So first name is label, right? First name is label. So appropriate tag to code this particular content is label tag, right? So in the label tag, okay, in the label tag, here there is a opening tag of label and here there is a closing tag of label. I gave content as first name, okay? So first name is text input, right? If you want to code first name, is then we'll be using text input, means we'll be expecting text input from our user, right? So I specified input type as text, okay? And I used name attribute, okay? I gave some unique name for this particular field. Why? Because with the help of name attribute only, our server can uniquely identify this particular field, right? Then ID attribute. Here I linked this label and this particular field, okay? So the value of the for attribute and the value of the ID attribute are same, right? Here also I gave F name and here also I gave F name. Then I gave value equal to admin, right? So value attribute will be used if you want to specify some default value. Here I specified default value as admin, right? Means if user didn't enter any first name, by default the value admin will get transmitted to server. If user wants, he can erase and he can enter any new first name, right? Then after that, I used placeholder attribute, enter your first name. With the help of placeholder attribute, I achieved this particular thing, okay? Inside this field, I can see this text, right? Enter your first name, right? Inside this particular field, you can see this particular text, right? So if you want to code this, you can code this by using placeholder attribute, right? Then as I said earlier, I want to provide such restriction. That means user can enter at most 30 characters alone. If user presses 31st character, it should not accept, right? So for that I used max length attribute, max length equal to 30, okay? Here user can enter at most 30 characters, right? If user presses 31st character, it won't accept. Then I said this particular field is mandatory field, right? So I used required attribute, okay? So attributes exist as name value pair, okay? Here name and value of the attribute both are equal, so I just specified name of the attribute alone, right? So likewise, I coded this particular first name field, right? Hope you all understand this particular field, right? Next, okay, I linked form fields and labels by using for attribute and ID attribute. Here you can see those things, right? So if I click this particular thing, this particular field will get highlighted. Default value will be admin. If user wants, he can erase it and he can type their own first name, right? Yes. Then password is label, right? So I coded password field in the label tag. Here you can see the opening tag of label and here you can see the closing tag of label, right? So between opening and closing tag you can see the content, right? So if you want to mask the characters, we need to use input type as password, right? So I used input type as password. I used name attribute here, Why? Because with the help of name attribute alone, our server can identify this particular field uniquely. And I linked form fields and labels here with the help of PAR attribute and ID attribute. And I used placeholder attribute, enter your password. So here you can see enter your password, right? And I used required attribute. Why? Because this is mandatory field, right? If user didn't enter any password, it won't accept. Okay, so this is mandatory field. So I entered, I used this password, I used this attribute required, right? Yes, we discussed till there. Now, if you want to code this particular upload picture, this particular field, so upload picture is label, right? So inside the label tag, here there is an opening tag of label and this is the closing tag of label. Here you can see the content upload picture, right? And I link label and form fields with the help of for attribute and ID attribute. The value of for attribute and the value of ID attribute is same, right? So if you want to upload a file, okay, if you want to upload a file, we will be using input type as file, right? And I use name attribute. Okay, with the help of name attribute, our server can identify this particular field uniquely. You can provide any unique name here, right? And I said upload picture. This field is mandatory, right? If I didn't choose any file, okay, if I didn't choose any file, it will show error. Please select a file like this. So for that, I used require attribute. Okay, if you want that particular field should be filled by your user compulsory means, then you can use required attribute. Right, yes, I linked label and form fields, right? Yes, we coded these three things. Now, what do you want to learn? Okay, so this is not a label here. Okay, HTML, CSS, JavaScript, these three things are label. Someone may consider these things as label. See, while linking form fields and labels, if I click label, then appropriate form field should get highlighted, right? If I click HTML, this particular thing will get selected. If I click CSS, this radio button will get selected. If I click JavaScript, this radio button will get selected, right? So these three things are labels. What do you want to learn? These things is not label, right? So I'm coding these things using paragraph tag. If you code this thing using label tag, then that is not a major mistake. Okay. Right. Okay. Yes. Now I coded this thing using paragraph tag. Now my system or my computer will consider these thing. What do you want to learn as paragraph? Right. So let me, if you want, you can put question mark here. This is question, right? So if you want, you can put question mark here. What do you want to learn? Right. Let me save it. Okay. Here you can see the question mark. Right. Then I coded these three things, HTML, CSS, JavaScript. For that, I need to use input type as radio. Right. So here I have used input type as radio. Right. Here you can see input type as radio. Then I need to provide unique name for each field. Right. So I provided name equal to learn. You can give any unique name, no problem. Then I linked label and form fields, right? So here you can see in the label attribute, in the label tag for for attribute, label tag, okay, not label attribute. Label is a tag, for is an attribute, right? So for attribute, I specified value as HTML, right? So here for ID also I specified value as HTML, means these two things will get linked. Similarly, here in the for attribute I specified value as CSS. Here also in the ID attribute I specified value as CSS, means these label and this particular field will get linked. Similarly, here I specified value as JavaScript. Here in the ID attribute I specified value as JavaScript, means this label and this form field will get linked. Right, here I specified value equal to HTML, value equal to CSS, value equal to JS. Means if user click HTML, that means if you use get method, name value pair will send to server, right? So name means this name, okay? So if user click HTML, learn equal to HTML, this information will send to server. If I click, if user click CSS, learn equal to CSS, this thing will send to server. Okay, if user click JavaScript, right, this learn equal to JS. Why? Because value is JS, right? This thing will send to server. Okay, if these things want, if you want to send these things to server explicitly, means you will be using get method. Or if you want to send these things behind the scenes, means you will be using post method, right? Yes, right? Yes. Okay, so as I said earlier, this HTML should get selected by default, right? So I used checked attribute here, so it will get selected by default, right? Yes. Likewise, you need to code this particular field, right? Yes. Then you need to code this thing, your knowledge level in HTML. This is what label, right? So I opened a label tag here and I closed the particular label tag over here. So this is what the label, content of label, your knowledge level in HTML. I linked form field and label here. I linked form fields and labels using ID attribute and for attribute. I specified value as range for attribute and ID attribute. Okay, I specified input type as range to code this particular thing. Next, I gave some unique name for this. Okay, with the help of this thing, our server can identify. Then I specified step equal to 5. If you want more step or if you want less step, you can specify according to that, right? That means it will get incremented by 5 or it will get decremented by 5, right? Yes. If you are a beginner, you can select this particular 0 level. Okay. Or if you are expert in HTML, you can select this thing. If you have intermediate knowledge, you can select according to this, right? Here I specified step equal to 5. So it will get incremented or decremented by 5, right? Yes. Okay. Hope you know how to code this particular range field. Then I grouped these 5 fields, right? So for that, I used field set tag, right? So here you can see field set tag. Appropriate field set tag is closed over here, right? Then here you can see title as user's information, right? So if you want to code a title for a set of related fields, we'll be using legend tag, right? So inside the legend tag, I coded this particular title, user's information, right? Yes. Now, so far I explained these things, right? Yes. Now let me explain these things. First, email, okay? So email is the label, right? So I used label tag here, okay? I used label tag here. And I closed that particular label tag over here. Content is email, right? Content is email. So if you want to get email from your user, appropriate input type is email input type, right? So I specified input type as email, right? And name is equal to email. Okay, each and every field should contain some unique name, right? So I specified name is equal to email. I linked this particular label and this particular field using for attribute and ID attribute. Okay, to link these two things, the value of the for attribute and the value of the ID attribute should be same, right? And here you can see this text, enter your email address. So to achieve this, I'm using placeholder attribute, enter your email address, right? And I said this particular field is mandatory field. Okay, this particular field is mandatory field. So I used required attribute over here, right? Likewise, I coded this particular field, right? Next, phone number field, right? So phone number is label, right? So here you can see the opening tag of label, and here you can see the appropriate closing tag, and here you can see the content, right? So phone number is the content, right? So here you can see input type as number. If you want to get phone number from your user, appropriate input type is number inputs, right? So input type, I coded input type as number, right? So I used name attribute. With the help of name attribute, our server can identify this particular field uniquely. Here I linked label and this particular field. Okay, the value of the for attribute and the value of the ID attribute is similar, right? Then here you can see some text, enter your phone number, right? So I coded this particular thing with the help of placeholder attribute, enter your phone number. And as I said, phone number field is mandatory field, right? So here you can see the required attribute, right? Yes. Likewise, I coded these things. Right? Yes. Next, here. Let me explain this Twitter URL. Okay. Twitter URL is label, right? So I coded these things using label tag. Here there is the opening tag of label, and here is the particular closing tag. Twitter URL is the content, right? Yes. And I linked this particular label and form fields with the help of this for attribute and ID attribute. For the value of the for attribute and the value of the ID attribute, same, right? So I linked form fields and labels with the help of for attribute and ID attribute. If you want to get some URL, we need to use input type as URL, right? So I used input type as URL and I gave some unique name to this, right? So inside this, you can see enter your Twitter URL, right? So by using placeholder attribute, I achieved this enter your Twitter URL. Okay. So this is not mandatory. So I didn't use required attribute. Okay. Because someone may not have Twitter account. Right. So this is not mandatory. Right. Okay. Next, if you want to code this drop down menu, means what you need to do first? First, you need to open select tag and you need to close that particular select tag. In this particular drop down menu, here you can see how many things. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, right? So I opened 8 option tag and I closed 8 option tag over here, and I coded these things. Select your country: India, Malaysia, Singapore, China, Pakistan, America, and others, right? Yes. Here, for each and every field, there should be unique name, right? So here you can see name is equal to country, right? So I linked label and form field. So in for attribute, I gave value as country. Similarly, for ID attribute also, I gave value as country. This country is label, right? So for that, I opened a label tag and I closed label tag. I gave content as country, okay? So each user may belong to at most one country, right? So this drop-down menu is capable of selecting only one choice at a time, right? Yes. Now I grouped these four fields, right? Email, phone number, Twitter URL, and country, right? So for that, I'm using field set tag here, right? So here you can see the opening tag of field set, and here you can see the closing tag of field set, right? So title for these set of fields is contact details, right? So if you want to give title for set of fields, the appropriate tag is legend tag, right? So by using legend tag, I gave title, right? So this is the opening tag of legend, and this is the closing tag of legend, and this is for the content, right? Yes. So far we coded till there, right? Now let me explain these things. Okay. Okay. Now search. Okay. Search means if you want to browse anything, you can browse here, right? So appropriate input type to code this is search inputs, right? So I used input type as search, right? And I used name attribute over here. With the help of name attribute, our server can identify this particular value uniquely. Okay, our server can identify this particular field uniquely. I linked label and form fields. So here you can see the value of for attribute and the value of ID attribute is same. And here you can see some text, right? Browse anything if you need. I achieved this with the help of placeholder attribute, right? Yes, this search is label. So I coded this particular thing using label tag, okay? Likewise, I coded this thing, right? Next, comments. Comments is label, right? So I used label tag over here and I closed that particular label tag over here. Content is comments, right? So here, for is equal to comments. The value of for attribute is comments. Here the value of ID attribute also comments. So I linked form fields and labels, right? So if you want to get large input from your users, which consists of multiple lines, you need to use text area tag, right? So I opened a text area tag over here and I closed text area tag over here, right? If you use input tag, no need to close. Why? Because input is one of the self-closing tag. But text area is not self-closing tag. So if you open text area tag, you need to close it. Right? Here I used name. Okay, name attribute. I specified some unique name for it. Okay, and I said 5 rows should be displayed there. Right? So by using rows attribute, I achieved this. I specified rows equal to 5. And as I said, in a line, 25 characters should be displayed or visible, right? So to achieve this, I used calls attribute. I used calls is equal to 25, right? Then placeholder attribute. Here you can see some text, right? If you have any comments, please enter here, right? So by using placeholder attribute, I achieved this thing, right? Likewise, I coded this particular text area field, right? Yes. Then finally, this checkbox. If you want to code checkbox field, you need to use input type as checkbox, right? You need to use checkbox input. So I used input type as checkbox over here, okay? And I used some name over here. Name is equal to check, right? Here, I made one mistake to explain you clearly. As I said in previous videos, if you want to code some checkbox, what you need to do? In the value of name attribute, you need to use square brackets, right? So I didn't use square bracket over here. If I code like this, what will happen? Second value will get overwritten by next value, right? Means, If you click anything, okay, if you click one option, then if you click next option, okay, latest option alone will get transmitted to your server, right? For example, if I select this particular text box, after that, if I select this particular text box, okay, this particular text box will overwrite this particular text box, right? Means, the latest value alone will get transmitted to our server. So while coding text box, square bracket is must. Okay. So I didn't use square bracket to explain you these things. You may do this mistake. Okay. So that I explained here. Right. Square bracket is must. Okay. If you didn't use square bracket, second value will override the first value. Right. Second value, first value will get overridden by second value. Second value will get override the first value. That means latest value alone will get transmitted to server. Okay, so square bracket is must, right? Then I use the ID attribute over here. Okay, ID attribute over here to link label. Okay, to link label and form field. Right, here you can see the value of the for attribute and the value of the ID attribute are same. And I used value here. Okay, that means if I click this particular thing, value equal to PP will send to server. Similarly, if this checkbox is enabled, means value equal to TC will send to server. These two checkbox should be selected by default so that I used checked attribute here. Right, likewise, I coded these things. Right, finally, submit button. So here there is no label, so it is not necessary to link form fields and labels. So I used input type as submit. I gave some unique name over here. Name is equal to submit. Okay, and I gave value as send, right? Okay, and I gave value as send. Likewise, I coded, right? So now here you can see I used post method, right? Method equal to post. Why? Because I want to transmit my data to server behind the scenes. So the appropriate method is post method, right? If you didn't specify any method, default get method will get executed. Okay. So if you want to transmit your data behind the scenes, you need to use post method, right? And my file should get transferred to the file which contains the programs for the data to get processed, right? So for that, I used action attribute. Okay, here I used next.php. So this is some backend programming. We'll be learning these things while learning about PHP. And what is the purpose of this particular attribute? I am transferring binary data over here, right? I'm transferring binary data over here. So if you want to transfer binary data, you need to use this particular attribute. okay, encryption type attribute, and you need to specify value as multi-part form data, right? Otherwise, if you didn't use this particular attribute, only the file name will get transmitted to our server. Okay, if you want to transmit our entire file, not only file name, if you want to transmit your entire file, you need to use this attribute, right? Yes, this is what today's exercise. Hope you all have coded successfully. Now let me fill and show you once here, right? So let me remove this username. Let me provide some other username here, like Maunika. Let me enter some password, right? Let me choose some file here. Let me choose some JavaScript. Okay, now let me change my level over here, right? Then let me specify some mail ID. Let me specify some phone number here, right? Let me specify some phone number over here. Then let me specify some URL. Okay, let me specify some URL over here, right? Then let me select some country. Okay, so I don't want to search anything. I don't have any comments. Okay, I selected these two things. Okay, now if I click send, okay, it will transfer to a file which contains the programs for the data to get processed. Okay, this file we can make by using backend programming. So I'll be explaining this thing while learning PHP, right? So after that, the data is transmitted to server behind the scenes, right? For that, I used post method, right? This is how this is working. Okay, you need to remind one more thing. You need to use square bracket over here, because if you didn't use square bracket, okay, latest value alone will get transmitted to your server. Previous value will get overridden by next value, right? So this is what the main mistake all peoples will do. Okay, so please don't do this mistake. So if you want to code checkbox, please put square bracket over here, right? Yes, hope you have coded these things successfully. Yes, hope I have completed today's agenda. So we coded a simple exercise number 8, which is related to forms, and I summarized the concept of HTML forms in today's video. Yes, with that, the concepts of HTML forms are over. Hope you all enjoyed this video. Yes, we completed HTML forms concept. So if you have any doubts or if you have any difficulties, you can ping me in the comment section. Yes, thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you so much for patience listening. Thank you so much for watching this video. If this video is useful to you, kindly subscribe our channel and click the bell icon so that you will receive all notifications of my useful videos then and there. If you like this video, please hit the like button. Share this video to your friends and relatives, those who are interested in learning HTML or those who are interested to become a web developer. If you have any doubts or if you have any suggestions, if you feel any inconvenience, you can ping me in the comment section or you can mail me personally. My mail ID is in the description box. You can mail me. Thank you so much. Thanks for watching this video. Congrats in advance to become a web developer. Yes, it's time to end this video. It's time to wind up my session. Thank you so much. See you all in my next video. Till then, bye-bye. Take care. Bye-bye.